Hey everyone, it's Race Robinson, your Florida mortgage loan specialist. Hope you're off to a great day and great week. Wanted to check in with something that I get asked, which is, what's the difference between buying a home with an FHA loan versus a conventional loan? And there are some big differences and most people really don't understand them. And it is important because I see people all the time that bought a home as an FHA loan when they should have done it as a conventional or vice versa. So, you know, there are advantages and disadvantages to both of them. So first, let's take a look at FHA. There's a tremendous amount of FHA financing happening here in our market in Florida. So let's take a look at that first. Come with me and I'll show you the differences.
Okay, so let's look at FHA financing. Of course, one of the big benefits with FHA is a low down payment, currently 3.5%. So you really can buy a $200,000 house with $7,000 down. That is extremely low. Interest rates, all rates right now are extremely low, but FHA definitely has the best rates of all the programs. So that is one nice thing with FHA, are the extremely low rates. 6% in seller paid closing costs. That's a big deal because even on the lower price ranges with an FHA loan, you can have the seller pay all of your closing costs and what they call your escrows or prepaids, which are things like homeowners insurance. So you really can buy a house with FHA for just 3.5% down. The credit scores with FHA are more liberal than any other program. You can go down to 620. And another nice thing is they don't tier the rate. So there's not a big difference in interest rate from somebody that has a 750 score versus a 620 score. And last but not least are the higher ratios. Typically on an FHA loan, you're going to qualify for more house than you would on a conventional loan. And one nice thing that's not on this list is FHA does allow gifts. So you can get a gift from a relative or a blood relative or a family member. Some things you need to know with FHA is they do charge a funding fee of 1.75%. And that's expensive. For every $100,000, about $1,750 goes to FHA. Now that gets rolled into the loan so it doesn't affect your down payment, but that's still a big cost of doing an FHA loan. Also, there's not much benefit for putting more money down with FHA, unlike a conventional loan. And then the monthly mortgage insurance at 1.25% does make the FHA payment higher than a conventional loan because the monthly MIP is almost double what it is on a conventional loan. And then last but not least is you cannot drop a PMI until the loan is paid down. You can't use the appreciation or an appraisal to force the lender to drop the PMI. Now with conventional financing, basically, a lot of people don't realize you can do 5% down, which is pretty low for conventional financing, but you do have to have higher credit scores to do that. The PMI is much, much lower on a conventional loan, and you can drop the mortgage insurance with an appraisal. So if you buy a house and it appreciates, or you buy a house and get a really good deal, you don't have to pay the loan down the full 20% to drop the PMI. You can actually do an appraisal and force the lender to drop it. And then, of course, with FHA, you get better rates and terms for bigger, you know, for bigger down payments. So there's a big advantage on a conventional loan, unlike FHA, to actually put more money down. Now, one thing with conventional, the rates are higher, a little bit higher than FHA, but again, the monthly MIP is lower, so it actually usually evens out that a conventional loan has a lower payment than an FHA loan. Tighter ratios mean that on a conventional loan, you actually, for most people, qualify for less house. And then the seller can only pay 3% of the cost. So typically you are going to bring some of your own money, not only for the down payment, but for the closing costs as well, especially in the higher price ranges. And again, FHA does tier their rates based on credit score and down payment. So the higher the credit and the more you're putting down, the better deal you're going to get on a conventional loan.
Okay, so there you have it. Those are the big differences between FHA and conventional. There are some other little differences. For instance, FHA is a little stricter on the appraisal than a conventional loan. If the house needs a little bit of work, honestly, in my experience, there's not a huge difference. A lot of real estate agents do think a conventional buyer is stronger than an FHA buyer. So if you're competing with another buyer on a house, it could be better to have a conventional offer to have your offer get preference. Truthfully, it's going to be depending on your situation on what the best way to go is. Everybody's going to be different. And that's something that you can give me a call and we can look into based on your scenario. So with that, if you have any questions on this, definitely give me a call. If you know anybody that would benefit or that would be interested in this video, definitely forward it or share it. So with that, have a great day. Again, call me if you have any questions, and I'll talk with you soon.